It's AumSum time.
What if football disappeared?
Oh no, I was sure of winning the World Cup this time.
Oh, AumSum.
To buy this t-shirt, visit AumSum.com.
Firstly, if football disappeared, other sports like hockey, cricket, tennis may become more popular. Secondly, regularly playing football is considered a good form of exercise. If football disappeared, many players may start putting on weight. Thirdly, more than half of the world's population watched the FIFA World Cup 2018. If football disappeared, many people may abandon their TV sets. Fourthly, if football disappeared, Lionel Messi and Cristiano Ronaldo, football's biggest superstars, may not remain that popular anymore. Fifthly, football is a national passion in Brazil. If football disappeared, entire country may go on a strike. Lastly, if football disappeared, sale of sports shoes may plummet. What causes swelling?
Dreaming about balloons causes swelling.
Nah. Swelling or edema usually occurs when tiny blood vessels leak fluids into the surrounding tissues. Some causes of edema are as follows. Firstly, our liver releases a protein called albumin into the bloodstream. Albumin keeps fluids from leaking out of the blood vessels. However, in a serious liver condition called cirrhosis, it cannot produce enough albumin. Without albumin, our body can't prevent fluids from leaking, thus causing swelling. Secondly, in nephrotic syndrome, the filtering parts of kidneys called glomeruli get damaged, causing excess loss of proteins like albumin, thus leading to swelling. Thirdly, growing uterus can put pressure on the veins present in the legs of pregnant women, causing blood to pool, gradually forcing fluids to leak, and thus causing swelling. However, not all swelling is bad because during an infection, excess fluids and immune cells reach the infected site to fight germs. This can also cause swelling, but in this case, it is good for our body. What is dwarfism?
It is the study of magnetism.
Nah. Dwarfism is a condition categorized by short stature or stunted growth. In this condition, an adult individual's height is 4 feet 10 inches or less. Dwarfism is divided into two main categories, proportionate and disproportionate. In proportionate dwarfism, overall growth of torso, hands, and legs is restricted, but the body is in proportion. In disproportionate dwarfism, particularly hands and legs are smaller than average, but other body parts are of normal size. Let's see some of the main causes of dwarfism. Firstly, inadequate production of growth hormone by the pituitary gland located in the brain. Secondly, a mutation in the FGFR3 gene which hinders the skeletal development. Thus, most of the cartilage doesn't get converted into bones. Lastly, Turner syndrome, a genetic condition in which a female is partly or completely missing an X chromosome, causing stunted growth. Why do people get ringworm?
Because diamond rings are expensive.
No. Ringworm is an infection not caused by worms, but instead by skin fungi called dermatophytes. Dermatophytes live in warm and moist places like soil, public showers, etc. When we come in direct contact with contaminated objects, dermatophytes attach to our skin. They feed on keratin, predominantly found in our dead skin cells, nails, hair, etc., and usually form red ring-like structures causing an infection called ringworm. Ringworm on our skin is called tinea corporis. Ringworm on our scalp is called tinea capitis. Ringworm around the inner thighs, buttocks, etc. is known as jock itch, whereas ringworm on the foot is commonly called athlete's foot or tinea pedis. Now, ringworm can cause various problems. Firstly, it can make our skin scaly, flaky, tender, and itchy. Secondly, it can also develop a pus-filled bump called carrion. Thirdly, ringworm on scalp can cause hair fall. Why do we get dehydrated?
'Cause our body needs more hot chocolate.
Nah. Dehydration occurs when our body loses more fluids than we drink. 75% of our body weight is water. Water regulates our body temperature, digestion, it acts as a lubricant and cushions our joints, etc. Now, we lose water through breathing, sweating, peeing, etc. As little as 2% loss of our body fluids makes us thirsty, and when we lose 4-5% of our body fluids, we begin to feel dehydrated. Common causes of dehydration include diarrhea, vomiting, and excessive sweating. Some conditions like diabetes and diuretic medications, which cause us to urinate frequently, can also leave us dehydrated. Now, mild dehydration can cause irritation, headache, dizziness, etc. However, long-term dehydration or chronic dehydration can lead to decrease in blood volume, thus reducing the amount of oxygen reaching our tissues. Chronic dehydration can even cause urinary tract infection, kidney failure, and in severe cases, death. Which is better, hot shower or cold shower?
No shower is the AumSum mantra.
So gross. Let's have a look at the advantages of cold showers first. As we are warm-blooded, the sudden sensation of cold water awakens our body, thus making us feel fresh and alert. Secondly, many scientists believe that when our body suddenly comes in contact with cold water, it sends a jolt of electrical impulses to our brain, helping boost our mood in the process. Lastly, cold showers may contribute to weight loss as our body might burn more fat to generate heat. Hot showers have the following advantages. Firstly, scientists believe that hot showers lead to the release of a hormone called oxytocin, easing anxiety and stress. Secondly, as hot showers can help clear the nasal passage, they might be beneficial for a person suffering from cold. Thirdly, hot water can help release tension and stiffness in our muscles. Lastly, hot water can kill bacteria, thus preventing infections. What if we replace water by soft drinks?
Nah, we should replace salads by burgers and french fries.
AumSum. If we replace our 8 daily glasses of water with 8 soft drinks, then we would be in a big trouble. In a real life incident, a woman drank soda instead of water for 16 years. She was hospitalized. She had irregular heartbeats and very low potassium levels. Artificial sweeteners and soft drinks can have laxative effects. Overconsumption of same can cause diarrhea. Many soft drinks contain caffeine. Overconsumption of caffeine can lead to loss of potassium via urine. Flow of potassium regulates our heartbeat. Low potassium levels may lead to heart palpitations or irregular heartbeats. Overconsumption of caffeine can also lead to insomnia. We might start staring more at stars instead of sleeping. Also, soft drinks are usually sugary drinks. Hence, this will also lead to weight gain or diabetes. What if we drink only seawater?
Nah, I only drink chocolate milkshake.
AumSum. On an average, seawater has salinity of about 3.5%. When we drink seawater, water as well as excess salt get absorbed in our blood. One of the functions of our kidneys is to remove this excess salt from our blood. But urine produced by kidneys has a salt concentration which is less than 3.5% of that of seawater. Hence, it needs more water to remove all the excess salt. As a result, we feel thirsty after drinking seawater. Excess seawater consumption can lead to dehydration. Secondly, excess drinking of seawater will also hinder the blood purifying process of our kidneys. How? Because solute concentration inside the filtering units of our kidneys will be lower than that of the highly saline blood. Hence, due to osmosis, blood doesn't get purified. What is gigantism?
It's the nickname of my friend the Great Hulk.
Nah. In our brain, a pea-sized structure called the pituitary gland produces growth hormone, helping regulate and increase our height, girth, weight, etc. However, in some rare conditions, a non-cancerous tumor in the pituitary gland can trigger it to produce far more growth hormone than the body requires, leading to a large, tall stature, and thus causing gigantism. One example of this condition is Igor Volkovinsky, the current tallest man in the United States. His height is 7 feet, 8.33 inches. According to experts, in such cases, the internal organs might become much bigger than their normal size. However, on the flip side, gigantism may lead to deformities in the muscles and bones, making it difficult for the person to perform daily tasks like walking, running, etc. What if wind suddenly stopped?
Whoa. Wind might stop, but AumSum the Great will never stop.
Stop it, AumSum. Firstly, if there was no wind in heavily industrialized places, pollutants would not disperse, making the air extremely toxic. Secondly, equator would get more hotter, while poles would get more cooler. Why? Because in the absence of winds, heat at the equator will not be carried to the poles. Thirdly, kite and sailing ship enthusiasts would be extremely unhappy as kites will suddenly fall down and sailing ships would suddenly halt. Fourthly, birds would be very sad as there would not be any free lift anymore. They will have to flap their wings all the time. Fifthly, as wings are a major source of pollination, without wings, plant life would greatly suffer. Sixthly, wind energy companies will not be happy with this sudden change. One plus point of wind stopping suddenly is that there will be no more tornadoes and hurricanes. What if there were no clouds?
No problem. I have my magic carpet.
AumSum. Firstly, without any clouds, sunsets would no longer look spectacular. Secondly, without any clouds, there would be no way to redistribute fresh water from one place to another. Why? Because no clouds means no rains. Eventually, all the water present on Earth would evaporate, and our Earth would begin to look like Mars, dry and barren. Thirdly, temperatures would suddenly rise during daytime and drop at night. Why? This is because clouds help regulate temperature. As clouds are generally white in color, they reflect a good amount of sunlight, thus helping keep our day temperatures down. But at the same time, at night, they don't allow all the heat reflected from Earth to escape, thus not allowing our nights to get too cold. How do hormones work?
They are lazy like me.
Not at all. In our body, there is an endocrine system which consists of several glands. These glands secrete various hormones and release them usually into the bloodstream. Now, our cells have specialized receptors on them. A hormone will attach only if there is a receptor for that hormone, ensuring that just the target cells get stimulated. When the cells get stimulated, specific processes in the cells increase or decrease. Thus helping us regulate our heartbeat, blood pressure, body temperature, sleep, etc., thus maintaining our health. For example, if blood sugar level drops, pancreas will secrete a hormone called glucagon. Glucagon will attach to receptors of liver cells and instruct them to convert stored glycogen into glucose, thus increasing our blood sugar levels. Thus, hormones are super important for our body. What if we drink too much tea?
Nothing is too much for the great AumSum.
AumSum. Tea plants absorb high amounts of fluoride from soil. Hence, tea leaves are a major source of fluoride. Small amount of fluoride is good for our dental health. But high doses of fluoride can prove to be detrimental to our health. Excess tea consumption can lead to dehydration. Tea contains antioxidants called tannins. Tannins have a number of health benefits, but their high intake may cause iron deficiency in our body as they interfere in the body's ability to absorb iron. Tea is also a source of caffeine. whose overconsumption can lead to insomnia, low potassium levels, as well as caffeine-induced anxiety disorder. Overconsumption of tea may worsen pre-existing medical conditions like anxiety or diarrhea. Finally, overconsumption of tea with artificial sugar will not be good news for your waistline.